Hello again, everyone. It's Vince Shuta here for Shuta Multimedia, coming to you once again from Olyphant, Pennsylvania, the city ranked by homesnacks.net as the third safest city in Pennsylvania. And why am I here today? For the battle of the bands. And why are the bands battling? Well, I guess you're just going to have to check it out. Let's go.
Flags for us. If we could ask everyone to stand in honor of their march in, please.
Dani-Elle to lead us in the national anthem, and this is small town America, and we stand for the national anthem.
Yeah, that's
right.
Yes, we can. Who's
the
by the dawn's what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, all the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming. Ooh.
introduce to you our President Judge Emeritus, Judge Thomas J. Bundley.
What a wonderful afternoon. Thank you so much, Jim. And George Atkinson, thank you so much for asking me to be here. And Dani-Elle, you did a wonderful job. I'm so proud of you. But we have a nice crowd here. I'm proud of everybody that's here. And our Commissioner Patrick O'Malley, and I have to say this about him. He did more for veterans than anybody that I know of in the last several years. Patrick O'Malley. And Reverend, you're doing a good job. Reverend, you're right next to Patrick. Keep him holy, will you, Reverend?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. But I want to say something to everybody who's here. Kim, you and George had a lot to do with this, and you really worked hard at it. I mean, the police officers are here. We have the veterans here. The streets are blocked. I mean, what a big event this is for veterans. Finally, people are starting to understand what veterans are all about. They appreciate veterans. They never did before. That's why I always said to Commissioner O'Malley every day, you do a wonderful job to help veterans. Keep it up. Everybody here, I'm trying to tell all of you, veterans don't ask for much. All they want once in a while is you to say, thank you for your service, give them a little handshake. That's all they want. They don't want anything. They're not looking for anything that's a big deal. But when you put that uniform on, folks, and all these veterans here will tell you, you are in a different world than everybody else. You have that uniform on, it changes the whole world around you. Nothing is the same. Nothing is the same. I remember when they sent me to Vietnam, I said, I hope I make it back to Lackawanna County. I was lucky enough to make it back. A lot of my friends didn't. But you know what? That's why the day I got back from Vietnam, many, many years ago, I said to myself, I served in the infantry for all that time. I will never, ever, ever go through one day without saying thank you to our veterans. And Kim and George Atkinson, you're just like that and you deserve it. And thanks everybody for being here.
Thank you so much, Judge. It's a pleasure to have you. You know, you're the first one I think of whenever we do something. Again, I want to thank Patrick O'Malley. Again, give him a big hand. He's always been here for us. He helps us with every veterans issue that we've had in the valley. Do you want to say a few words, Pat?
Ladies and gentlemen, it's an honor to be here in Olyphant. Sometimes I feel like I'm the adopted son here, and I mean it. The people are great. Can all of our veterans raise their hands out there today, please? All of them, raise your hands. Thank you for your service. Thank you so much. And Kim Atkinson and her committee, isn't the Freedom Fighter, that is going to be one of the greatest memorials, isn't it? It's going to be one of the best. Absolutely. Yeah, no, without question. No, I saw Mark, brother. Mark Zinskie, the creator of the Freedom Fighter. It's amazing. It's going to be reality. It's because of all the people here that it's going to happen. And just to be a little part and give it a grant from the county government, it's wonderful because we have to remember all of our servicemen and women. We wouldn't be standing here today. We wouldn't have a country. And you know what? That's our flag. And we should stand for our flag because that's the flag that drapes our heroes' caskets. This is our country, and it's the greatest country ever. This memorial that's going to be set up with the Freedom Fighters standing there is going to represent all the servicemen from the Gulf War up to today, to this moment. There's a need for it, so please make sure, I know there's more money to be had out here donation-wise, please get it to the committee. We need this statue. It's going to be a great memorial, and it's for those that are fighting on our behalf, some right this moment. Thank you, everyone. Thank you for being here. Have a happy, safe summer. Thank you.
Hi, Earl.
Earl!
Earl Granville.
You know, he came all the way in from Georgia, was it?
Yeah, I was in Georgia.
Yeah, to be with us today. So,
around the back.
All right, he's going to say a few words and tell you
little bit about what he does and how he does it. Oh, he's going to hop up here.
Yeah.
Stage dive, right? Bye, bye, guys.
Hey, how are you?
I think it was adequately saved. We're good here.
Hey, how you doing? Sorry to break your stuff, guys.
Hey, I was expecting to say a few words, but I just want to say thank you guys so much for doing this. I think it's awesome that we have a memorial for, not just our modern-day veterans, for global war and terrorism veterans. I gotta be honest with you, I feel like my generation of serving in the military, I feel like we get society really takes care of us. We always get a lot of attention. And I always look at something like this for our Vietnam veterans. Because I gotta be real, I feel like you guys paved the way for my generation, and how you were treated from society back then was a lot different. Like, I wasn't around back then, but I think we all know how things were back then, and I'm just so glad we turned things around. And to see this pride and passion within our armed forces members, and I couldn't be more honored to be a part of this community, and not just for serving, but I just feel like be a part of something like this small town showing their pride for our armed forces members. So all you guys out there who are making this happen, if there's anything I can do, I'd love to help out. And thank you again so much, guys. Appreciate it. So, I'm being asked to tell my story. You guys got a minute?
Yeah.
All right, guys. So, my name is Earl Granville. I'm a retired staff sergeant on the Pennsylvania Army National Guard. I was an infantryman for 9 years. And a little bit of what I do now, I work with two nonprofits. One is called Operation Enduring Warrior. The other one is called Oscar Mike. We help wounded and disabled veterans continue to live an active lifestyle after their injuries, not learn the disabilities that define who they are. And I'm a senior at the University of Scranton for Counseling and Human Services. I'm also 35 years old, so I'm basically Billy Madison, all right? So a little bit about that's what I do now. And guys, my whole reason to join the military, my twin brother and I joined together. He kind of talked me into joining. And while we were in boot camp together, 9/11 happened. And Joe was so gung-ho about it. This is just who he was, how he carried himself, and I was just the guy like, all right, man, cool, we'll get it done. We had two different attitudes and two different perspectives of wearing the uniform. I was for the education. Joe was for serving this country. So you can imagine when those towers got hit, how we both acted differently. I'll be honest with you. I didn't take it that positive. For the aspect of wearing the uniform, I was very nervous because I wanted to get that free education. It was about me. And that's just who I was as an 18-year-old when I joined the military. Joe, like he said, went the other way. We went to Bosnia together. Then he volunteered for Iraq, which made me volunteer as well. And that Iraq deployment, I got to tell you, ladies and gentlemen, made me love the military. Everything that Joe did and everything that Joe, I saw what he loved in it so much when I took that path of realize this isn't about me and my education. Something bigger than myself. And that's exactly what that Iraq deployment did for me. We had some hard times over there. I won't get into them, but it made me re-up my contract and realize this is what I want to do the rest of my life. We come home from Iraq. We get another warning order, and this one's for Afghanistan. And it was another volunteer mission, and I volunteered right away. And I knew this is what I wanted to do. Joe decided to stay back. Well, on this deployment, about 3 months into it, my vehicle gets hit by a roadside bomb, and my leg was taken through the knee, my left leg. More tragically, my two buddies got killed that day. Specialist Derek Holland, he's from Wing Gap, Pennsylvania, and Major Scott Haggerty, a 41-year-old civil affairs officer from Stillwater, Oklahoma. Derek was only 20 years old. I was very optimistic about what happened to me. I can be totally honest with you. I was moved last minute and it saved my life. And life is going to be good. We're going to move forward and push on with this, okay? 2 years after coming home from Afghanistan, all my physical therapy at Walter Reed, learning how to walk again, I get a phone call from my mother a week before Christmas. And when I first talked to her on the phone at that moment, she said my name so somber and she was crying. And I asked her, "Mom, what's the matter?" "Joe committed suicide." Worst day of my life, man. How can I get this second chance at life? And Joe takes his away. I don't know why, I don't know how, I don't know what the reason it is. I'm not saying it's post-traumatic stress. All I know is something in his life decided him to do that. And what I do now is I'm a public speaker, and in these organizations, I talk about those hard times of losing my brother and losing my leg. But understand something. What helped me get on a healthy path again? I now make a living talking about my brother, you know, the guy I share the womb with. Giving my ideas of healthy ways for us to help ourselves. You know, we have so many organizations out there that want to see our community, the veteran community, get out there and succeed in life and continue to move forward after what they endured in combat situations and just, you know, just the culture in general. Let's be real here. And there's so many resources out there for us. And I always hear we're not doing enough for our veterans. Now, people could debate me on this. I think we're doing so much for our veterans. I truly do. What I want us to figure out how to do is how do we help the veterans, the ones who are out there suffering, help themselves and understand, look, man, we're human. And we're going to face this S-H-I-T, sorry about that. We're going to face this stuff in our lives at some point. Okay, no matter who you are. Look, if you wear that uniform or not, we're all going to face heavy times in our lives. Okay? But we always have a choice. A choice on how to react to them. And also a choice to ask for help. Understand that. Like I said before, people always say, we're not doing enough for veterans. I truly believe there's a lot of resources out there. And in my line of work, I mean, I can tell you so many organizations, so many nonprofits, so many VA benefits where people can help themselves. Because after you take that uniform off, you have to find that new purpose in your life. On top of that purpose, find yourself a passion. And most importantly, just like when you wore that uniform, be a part of something bigger than yourself. Those three P's right there, purpose, passion, part of something. I know there's a lot of passion in this statue right here being made, ladies and gentlemen. What brings you all here today, right? Let's be real. Those three P's, how do we find them? Change the attitude. Get a healthy attitude. If you've got a bad attitude, you're never going to succeed. Number two, step out of that comfort zone. That's the hardest thing. I know it was hard for me. I had to go step and see a counselor at the vet center. You know how hard that was and difficult? But man, it saved my life after losing my brother. And number three, it's your self-responsibility to move forward and find that help that you need. Or whatever it is. You could call it help, you could call it resource, whatever it may be, help you find that happiness once again. Because you know what? No one can do it for you, and you're worth it. Guys, thank you so much. I appreciate it so much. And thank you so much for calling me out. But appreciate it, guys. Remember our Vietnam vets. Woo!
I just want to say something real fast because I already spoke, and I forgot to invite everybody here. I do a TV show every single night on Channel 28. All of you veterans or veterans in the family that want to be here, come on the show. Even though there's a several month waiting list, the Atkinses have been on many times. Earl Granville is going to come on. Earl cancels on me all the time, but he's going to be on. Mike McLean and I did a show that was shown all over the United States of America in Vietnam. He did it. Mr. Franco was on. People have been on the show. So call up my office, 963-6765, if you want to be on the show. Or call my brother Joe at his number, 878-5512. Bother my brother Joe. And he's sitting. He's standing there. But call up and we'll put you on the show. Ask him about it. Everybody watches it. Finally, they're doing something to help veterans. Thank you very much.
the king of Olyphants, Jerry Tully.
I stand here in the utmost of honor, respect, and dignity. I got drafted in 1968, and they didn't want me because I had polio. But my friends, Joel, Mike, Jane, my brother-in-law, Chet, you know? I mean, I saw you guys go. Sorry. But I was lucky enough to see you guys come back. I've tried my whole lifetime to support our armed forces, do things for the community, to promote the growth and importance of the people standing here in front of me. There are two people in this crowd right now who you cannot ever knock down off of their mountain. It's myself and Mark Zinskie. We are the only two people that have seen the Freedom Fighter in finished wax. This guy here, he might be crazier than an outhouse fly, but his heart is bigger than this town. What this man has sculpted is something that no one will ever exceed. I was very honored when asked by Kim and George to help with this project, and there's our boy George. And I felt after I got involved in this that this is my part of helping veterans. We just went down last Thursday and we saw this beautiful sculpture that is an exact copy of what Mark has made from, as he says, chicken bones and tissue. And the photo here to my right is an exact representation of what we are going to bring to all of it to honor not just modern day soldiers, but all veterans, past, present, and the guys that are still walking around. I had one veteran say to me this morning, "Oh, I'm an old veteran." No, there's no such thing as an old veteran. There are veterans. So, I mean, I don't like hearing that kind of stuff. But I've got, like I said, great friends who we all were supposed to go to Vietnam together. They chose not to take me because I have a paralyzed throat. I didn't think it was such a big deal because I had it so many years. But now I get to do something to promote a significant representation in admiration of the veterans of not just today, but of the past. This statue is something that there is not another in the whole United States. The little town of Olyphant with a 5,200 person population is going to be the only place you will come to see a representation of a true modern day warrior. We're going to put him right on the square next to the flagpole in honor of what you guys have done for us. And I hope you all will continually drive through town, think about the importance that this statue means to all of us, especially this lady here, you know. Nobody gets me out of bed early to do things but this lady. And it's a community coming together. Our council has been very good to us. As at this part, I'm part of the Freedom Fighter Committee, but I am also a councilman in this town. And everybody has come together to make this one of the most memorable pieces of art and the most respected and waiting to look forward. We're hoping, I mean, Mark will tell you, we were there the other day and Mark got to hold the wax replica, and there's photos on Facebook, and he did look really nice. He had his summer shorts on and stuff, you know. But we went down there with the hopes of bringing his original creation back. They needed it for some final touch-ups. Mark found he didn't like the way the thumb was on the wax one that's going to be made into the stainless steel monument, brushed stainless steel. So the guy said to Mark, "Well, here's the wax." And Mark corrected the issue in minutes. And I got to give you an attaboy for that, because I didn't want to go near it, let alone touch it. But you people are great. We want to thank you for being here. Mark, get up here. Come here. This guy has got to be not only one of the most talented men, but he's also the most humble. We can correct that once that statue comes to town. Thank you all for listening. Mark. Thanks, everybody, for coming out today. I can't believe that they blocked the road and let us have 8 bands here for a day of rock and roll. So, should be a fun day. But I'm grateful to the support that I've gotten from our borough, from all the veterans organizations, all the local politicians, all the politicians at every level, because everybody's trying to help see this become reality. It's close. I'm hoping that we can get it done no later than the spring, and if we can get it done earlier, we will. But I'd like to say this. Of course I'm proud as an artist that my work of art will be shown in town, but it's not about me. It's about the people that go overseas and protect our freedom with their lives and their struggle. It certainly can't be easy. It is about the vets. And our sentiment with this art piece is the modern day soldier. People are still dying, trying to preserve our freedoms. And it's time to honor them. Not just the people that make the ultimate sacrifice, but the people that come back and suffer the trauma of the experiences that they've gone through. I dedicate that artwork to them. Their lives are forever changed. And they do it for us selflessly. I thank all the veterans that ever served our great nation. And I'm proud to tribute it with the Freedom Fighter sculpture that'll be on that side of town. Thanks, folks. Thanks for coming out. We got a long day of rock and roll ahead. So have fun and be safe. Cheers.
Just a few quick words from me before we start this party rolling. How this is going to work. 8 bands. If you're a fan, come up to that table right there. The girls will explain to you how to band your votes together and make your vote count. Come up and vote for your favorite band. Around 8 o'clock tonight, we'll have the wing eating contest with the police, the firemen, the council, and the mayor. So you can vote there too. Talk to the girls at the table. They'll tell you how to vote. And we have a big screen TV to give away, 50-inch, and a beautiful hand-carved flag and a few other little items. Please help us achieve our goal today. We want to finish this Freedom Fighter next year. With your help, we will see it done. Thank you, America. Thank you, Hometown Olyphant. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, all the Legions and the VFW's Marine Corps Leagues. We love you. Thank you so much. Now, Dani-Elle and her wonderful band, almost direct from Nashville, right? Yes. Okay, here she is.
How's everybody doing today in downtown Olyphant?
Woo!
Oh, come on, you guys could do better than that. It's a Saturday, it's sunny, there's no rain. How are you guys doing today?
Woo!
All right. My name is Dani-Elle, this is my band. I'll introduce them in just a little bit. Thank you guys so much for coming on out and supporting the Freedom Fighter Monument. Thank you guys so very much. Of course, a salute to all our veterans that are here. Let's rock it. Thank you. no more. Just the bond. Just your words. Every musician that's going to be on this stage today, the purpose is that monument over there. And the goal is to raise as much money as possible today to keep building that monument, to bring it to life over there on the square in downtown Olyphant. So how this is working today is this is a battle of the bands. And the way that the winner is going to be decided is by all of you. Tent. guys so much. So do we have any country fans here today? Woo! Alright. We got some of you representing Nashville out there. We just got back from Nashville. We had the opportunity to play during CMA Fest, which is a big country music festival in Nashville where we basically honor the fans that are out there. There's like 90,000 country music fans. It's absolutely incredible, and we're so honored and blessed to play it every year. And we're going to be heading back down to Tennessee in September. We are going to be doing the Positive Youth Tour as well, which is something we get to go into high schools, talk about anti-bullying, talk about following your dreams, staying positive. And not only are we doing local schools, we're working on expanding that as well. And then we do a concert, which is it's one of the coolest things that we have gotten to do and that we get to do. Come on up. Thank you so much. Got it. Alrighty, I did just get word that the veteran mobile is here, all the way down the back. I think it is behind the bouncy house. So if anyone is here and does have questions regarding benefits or any other thing regarding Veterans Affairs, definitely head on back and see them. Yes, Kim. North American War Horse is back there with Indian Motorcycle. So make sure you guys head on back. There is food for sale, there's drinks for sale, there's so much going on here today, so make sure you call your friends, tell them come on down. This is all going on until 11:30 tonight, right? That's when the band is going to be announced and this is all going to end up. And there's some freebies, some free giveaways with the National Guard as well, so basically you guys just need to take a walk down Delaware here, because there's so much going on. Remember to be heading on over to that big trophy. If you would be so kind, give us a vote and a donation towards the Freedom Fighter Monument over here. That's what we're here for. To all of you who have given votes, who have been so generous, thank you guys so much. Yeah. Today to the monument, and she has coupons under the tent. Let's see, for $5 off any purchase of $10 or more. So make sure, as Ed calls them, he calls them coupons.
Coupons.
Go get a coupon under the tent there. Head on over, see Marissa. She is giving, like I said, a part of your purchase back to the foundation. So make sure you head on over. We got, I think we got time for one more song here, two more songs. We'll see how it plays out. I think two more. But this next song is actually my current and first song that has been released to country radio. And I'm really excited about that. So you can call into your local radio stations or SiriusXM and request Head for Home by Dani-Elle. Thank you so much, everybody who has been calling in. You guys are amazing. Just like anything else, we couldn't do this without all of you. So whether we're at home, whether we're on the road and traveling, it's all about hometown support. I'm going to give back the coupons. It's all about the hometown support, and it's so great to see so many familiar faces out today. Thank you guys for coming on out and supporting this wonderful cause. Stations and request this one. This is off my latest EP called Running on Dreams. It's a song that really means a lot to me, so I know I want it to be the first single to country radio. This one's called Head for Home.
How do you stop a heart from breaking? How do you keep a soul from shattering down? Thank you.
just a little bit. Once again, my name is Dani-Elle. I'm going to introduce my band in this last one. And we want to thank you guys from the bottom of your heart. Everybody who voted for us back there, thank you guys for donating for this incredible monument that is going to be going on up. I'm not quite sure how, I don't know, if after the bands are done, the voting is going to be taken away. I'm not sure. So if you want to get your last votes in for us, make sure you head on back, see the girl with the giant trophy. And make sure you give your donation. Make sure you want to say you want to give a vote for Dani-Elle. We greatly appreciate it. And it's been our honor being here today to help raise funds. George, Rob, everybody who had a hand in this today, thank you for asking us to be a part of our honor. All right, we're going to do a little Led Zeppelin for you now. Hey, Led Zeppelin fans, come on.
Woo! She reminds me of Light V.
Just before rain, I wrote a song to
Let's see if you guys remember this one.
Champagne, I'd rather drink beer all night in a tavern. I've been a
actress?
Hello.
Just capturing the awesomeness for the people on the web.
Vince Shuta Multimedia Productions, is that right?
Close enough for jazz, my friend. Well, and I know you know jazz. Enough. That's good, no, that's good.
Y'all like Lizzo?
Woo!
Come on, if y'all are gonna stand on your feet, I wanna see y'all dancing. Let's go! Mirror, mirror on the wall, don't say, cause you know I'm cute. Louis now doing drugs, LPL on my shoes. I'm dripping summer sauce, got a pen looking like ragu. Little bit like a crystal ball, that's cool, baby, so is you. That's how I roll. If I'm shining, everybody's gonna shine. I was born like this, don't even gotta try. I like shouting, they get better over time. Heard them say I'm not the baddest chick you like. It ain't my fault that I'm out here getting loose. Gotta blame it on the juice, gotta blame it on my goose, baby. It ain't my fault, gotta put it in the proof. Gotta blame it on my juice, gotta blame it on my juice. Have to take your chick. Shh. When I'm shining, everybody's gonna shine. I was born like this, don't even gotta try. I like shouting, they get better over time. Heard you say I'm not the baddest chick you like. Come on! It ain't my fault that I'm out here getting loose. Gotta blame it on the goose. Gotta blame it on my juice, baby. It ain't my fault, gotta put it in the proof. Gotta blame it on my juice. Gotta
Wow.
Small town drama.
You guys want to know who we are? My name is Leah Beth Evans. This is Christian Gratz, and we are the Frost Duo. We hope you guys are having a good time so far. We have a quick announcement.
Okay, I got to thank all you people for being here tonight, because you know what? We're generating funding to finish the Freedom Fighter Memorial. The only country in the United, or the only state, city, whatever, in the United States that is going to have this monument is going to be Olyphant, Pennsylvania. And you people are the people that made this happen. Okay, now we got to get down, because this lovely lady let me have the microphone. We got a guy from O-Town who is going to eat chicken wings. And I thought it was you, brother, and I thought, the old man here is in trouble.
Johnny loves chicken. Do you like chicken wings, Johnny?
We're going to have a chicken wing eating contest. For some reason, I'm finding that hard to say quickly. But we are going to be represented in the chicken wing eating contest by council, who is Moa. Thank you all. We have the police being represented by Timmy Kramer, who is one of our star full-time police officers. The mayor of Olyphant said he couldn't do it, so the guy from O-Town's coming here to rock it out. And the fireman representative is going to be Mike Abda. Mike and I have been on council together a long time, so guess what? No holds barred. I didn't eat all day, so I could eat. I had a couple of those fish bowls. I may be floating around a little bit. But you know what? I'll eat the chicken wings. So if anybody wants to vote to see who the ultimate chicken wing eater is, I don't know if that sounds proper. But okay, proper is not a thing we're worried about tonight. What we're doing here is trying to generate funding.
I would like to win that award, because I love chicken.
You want to stand in for me?
No, I can't.
Why can't you?
Because.
I can let you. I'll swear you in as an honorary council person.
You said
this guy here is ready, willing, and going for it. But, okay. This is something we're going to do to try to raise additional funding for the base for the Freedom Fighter Memorial. There are only two people in this town, and I said it before, who has actually seen the Freedom Fighter Memorial ready to go to brush stainless steel. The man who created it, Mark Zinskie, right there in the blue shirt. Pick that hand up in the air proud, brother.
Okay.
And the other guy who is his chauffeur to pick it up, bring it back, and float it around is me. But we are two of the very proudest people that there will ever be in this world today. So we're trying to generate the rest of the funding necessary. $45,000 has been accumulated by the man and the woman standing back there, the guy in the black cutout shirt, and his lovely and wonderful wife, Kim. George and Kim Atkinson. They spent multiple hours, weeks, years generating the funding necessary to do something that nobody in the United States has. It's a statue, a monument, something to depict what the freedom fighter is. That people who are fighting right now, who are not in any war, but are in harm's way, to protect our freedom, our dignity, and the right to be able to live as we live today. So all these people involved here, if you could give them a big round of applause, because they all deserve it.
Woo!
Okay, vote for who's gonna win the biggest chicken wing eater position, I guess that's called. Okay, thank you, we're gonna do that in a little while, and you know, you got the best of music here available. We got two wonderful people.
Hey, Mark.
Thank you, brother. Thank you, honey. And I get kisses from girls. Thank you, everybody. And please, enjoy your evening, because there's way more stuff to come at you.
God bless America. Beautiful country.
I'm on someone else to buy up.
second. It's a suicide awareness song. We think that's really important to talk about because not enough people talk about it. And it's almost September. It's not really September yet. It's almost August. But in like over a month, it'll be September. And September is Suicide Awareness Month. So we're gonna play a song for you guys. It's called Not Your Time, and it is by us, the Frost Duo. And we hope you guys listen to the message and enjoy the song.
And it's only
get your attention. You just went right on. That's okay, because you're cute, you can get away with that. Okay, we still have a whole bunch of people ready to sign up for the votes for the chicken wing eating deal. Anybody who wants to sign up to back council, firemen, the mayor skipped out, so we got a guy from the O-Town doing it, and the police, Timmy Kramer, one of our star full-time police officers here in Olyphant. So if any of you want to sponsor votes for this, remember, every dollar you spend in voting goes right towards the
third safest city in Pennsylvania.
And we're going to make this mount that the freedom fighter will stand on, something the rest of this world drools over. Because Olyphant, with a population of 5,200, will be the only city in the whole United States, the only town, that will have a memorial to the modern-day freedom fighter. So any money you spend voting for the chicken wing eating guy, we don't have any girls, but I mean, okay, but we got a couple guys, but call the people over walking around with these silly little books. I don't have an ink pen, I don't know how you're gonna write, but that's okay, we'll figure out a way. But please, vote for who you believe is going to be the ultimate chicken wing eating professional. And, you know, these guys here playing are absolutely fabulous. And, you know, you're great on that guitar, but I gotta tell you something, sweetheart, you're great on the mic. Thank you very much.
Thank you. All right, somebody just yelled out, Fleetwood Mac. We're gonna do that for you guys.
Woo!
What do you wanna hear?
All of it! Every song!
Let's take it to the front.
Facebook, The Frost Duo. You can find us on Spotify. Please go follow us on Spotify.
Woo!
Most importantly, please go follow O-Town Bar and Grill on Facebook as well. We got one more for you guys by request. This is some Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper.
That's the kind of thing you're gonna get when you order wings here at O-Town. And they're tasty. Oh yeah. Oh yes, they're tasty.
Can I have our four wing eaters up to the table, please? We have the firemen, policemen, council.
Okay, so I see figuring four plates and then a couple bonus. It depends on who can get to the bonus plates.
the vacant mayor. So it's J-Lo.
Yay!
So listen, if there's anybody out there that still would like to vote, we have Jerry Tully, okay, for council. We have our police officer, Mr. Kramer, here, okay, for the police department. We have Jay Luke for the mayor, substitute. And where's Mr. Abdi? Get over here, Mr. Abdi. Who wants to vote for Mr. Abdi? You still have time. They have 5 minutes to eat. But if you vote, it will increase their winnings.
Who's the beer runner?
Ryan.
Well, you want to drink here? You got a little shirt? Ryan, who runs for the beers? Drinking on the street when you eat this is legal.
Okay. The winner of this event, along with their votes, we're going to count how many wings that they eat. So they have 5 minutes to eat as many wings as they can. So gentlemen, start your engines, have a seat. Uh-oh.
Wait, chair. My chair.
You're over there,
dude. That's only four of you.
Explain to everybody, I'm rather disappointed.
All right. Anybody else want to vote before the eating starts?
Come on, this is money for the freedom fighters.
Okay.
Okay. Go, Mr.
Love.
Let's go.
Okay. I'm going to time it. You have 5 minutes.
Steady wins the race.
Okay, on your mark, get set, go.
Nom, nom, nom.
Come on, we need some cheers. Look at Jerry. Oh, my God. He's sucking them down. Kramer's at it. Oh, my God, Mr. Abdo's at it. And J-Lo.
Excuse me.
Oh. They have their wet towels ready.
I still win. Everybody wins. Trophies for everybody.
Slow and steady.
That was my answer for the fact that I wasn't keeping track. I just did the picture.
Do they win anything?
Where's your water?
No. Oh, you just raised the
cool.
What did you do?
No, it's a great cause.
If you vote for who you want,
yeah, you bet you too much. Oh, okay. They're starting to slow down. That's hard. That meat is really a lot of fat in that each one.
There's technique to the whole thing.
You ever watch the eaters on TV?
Coming on, 2 minutes.
Oh, man, they suck them.
3 minutes left.
Oh, looks like Abby's doing good too.
I'm going in for the Zoom
All
chat.
Right, dude, do it.
Holler out some names out there. Who do you want to win? Holler out for your best winner. Come on, vote Cherry. They're Cherry.
Stab this
I don't even think this is close. You know, there may be chicanery, but you know. Well, they gotta count them, and then they gotta count the votes. There's the votes matter too.
Wait a minute, we gotta do it over.
Here, put this on your head. President of Council, get over here. Let the UE come.
Gary, were they hot or mild? Were they hot or mild? For the record.
I don't even know. I didn't taste them long enough.
How's everybody doing tonight? Alright. We're in Project 90s. We feel very privileged to follow the Frost. They're awesome.
One, two, 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 one.
Comes. All right, everybody.
The old town. Rob, yo, put your hand up in the air.
Put your hand in the air.
This is the man who helped work this wonderful function tonight. We got three of the best cops this country ever had right in front of us. We got Timmy Kramer, who doesn't have enough back support, brother. You stuck that up in my face, didn't you? Well, guess what, Timmy? I won. Danny Volpe and DJ Sikelski. Wonderful cops in this town. Cops that'll talk to any individual and make you feel comfortable about needing them in a case of an emergency. I am so proud of the town of Olyphant. I've been a councilman for 22 years. I can't wait to do four more, so it'll be 28. I'm hoping I get voted in. But you people are the ones who are making the town of Olyphant, which has a population of 5,200 only, have the only statue commemorative to the freedom fighter. We got our chief there, Jimmy DeVoe, who has done a wonderful job taking care of our cops and the way they work this town. But this town is truly one of the most fabulous places in the world to live. I've been here a long time because I am very old. But I want to thank you people because you people are the people that make Olyphant the great town that it is. So, big round of applause for all you people because you're doing this. We're having the Freedom Fighter Memorial built and nobody in this country is going to top us. Thank you all.
I'm
say. Just to put up with this every day and all day. And how do I wind up this way? Watching the words and the words that we say. It's not the stimulation. Where the soul and the souls that we choose. How many days disappear? When you're walking too far for the price is choose. Your clothes never wear as well the next day. Hair never falls in quite the same way. You never seem to run out of things to say. Sister, the first thing she hears from the world. But she looks so sad and lonely there. Mother, when she Megan right there, that's awesome.
Oh,
our cops, our ambulance drivers, our servicemen. We must see who they are. If you see anybody, shake their hands because they help us, because without them, we are nothing. Let's give them a round of applause.
Woo! I personally would like to thank Vodka for making this possible for me.
We have so many chances to be together. They've sang on our stage. I'm so proud of them. Those guys are awesome.
How about the voice on Leah Beth? Oh my God.
She's amazing.
That's why it's the Frost. Man.
Ridiculous.
Is that why they call them the Frost?
Chris Gratz.
Yeah, one of them. Chills, man. Just give me chills.
Unbelievable.
Chris Gratz gave me my first guitar lesson, by the way, a long, long time ago. He's much, much older than myself, though. I just wanted to let you know.
Up next to you, and when I go out, yes, I know I'm gonna be the man who goes along with you. And when I get drunk, yes, I know I'm gonna be the man who gets up next to you. And if I hammer, yes, I know I'm gonna be the man who's hammering to you. I'm gonna walk 500 miles, man. Every penny out to you.
yes, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man who's lonely without you. And when I'm dreaming, yes, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man who dreams when I'm with you. When I get drunk, yes, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man who gets drunk next to you. When I come home, yes, I know I'm gonna be. I'm gonna be the man who's coming home to you.
Shut up.
when all you need is a night to meet the man of your dreams, then meeting his beautiful wife. And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? A little too ironic.
So you gotta hold on. job waiting for the night to we'll be right back.
goes like this. Way down inside.
Well, lately, girl, you'll be your picture, just a diamond.
Waters. Good night.
Thank O Town, thank Mark Zinskie, thank you, Chris, for doing the sound and for having us here. I hope you guys all enjoyed yourself.
Jimmy World. Yeah.
too much. You guys know this next one. It's from Lit. This might be your only chance to dance in the streets of Olyphant, so...
I am the girl.
Not necessarily three. All right, we're going to take it back with this next one. British Invasion. A band I'm sure some of you have heard of.
On me, it all keeps adding up. Yeah. fits together. I'm going to Wichita, far from this opera forevermore. I'm going to work the show, make the sweat drip out of every pore. The winner here and bring this great event to an end. Except from Third Eye Blind.
Down. Music in for you guys as possible in the remaining time. That's all we're trying to do here.
Raised in a field.
event, for having us here today, having all the great bands here today. A couple of us are from Olyphant, so this is a cause near and dear to our heart. Queen City residents, or we got one more for you, if that's okay.
Third City in PA.
That's right, third City in City, PA. Well, thank you. Well, thank you very much. We got a beautiful plaque here, all right. So now.
We got one more song
for the night. This is it though, guys, it's it for the night. You know, we got the announcement and everything.
Woo!
So, let's party like we do it in the Queen City here. We're nothing yet, and we want you to talk dirty to us.
Okay, now, I do have to say, the
phone, just don't take it.
Every band that played here tonight was magnificent. The best variety of music I have ever heard or seen in any venue. It was what stopped the ball open, wasn't it? Yeah. And the votes were based on how much, not just a vote per vote, but how much money was raised for the Freedom Fighter. And that was the best way we could think of to help raise the funds. And some of them came in with big donations. So that's how the votes ran, and then by popular vote as well. So we had to add up all together. And I'm going to leave these out so you can see the results if anybody wants to see. But our winner of the Battle of the Bands tonight is Dani-Elle Kleha. Come on up here. And band, of course. What would she be without her band? But what would they be without her? Yeah. Up if they want to say a few words, thank the crowd and thank everybody for supporting them and donating to the Freedom Fighter, and I'd just like to get a picture of them accepting the trophy.
Have them hold it up.
I do just want to say really quick, first of all, give a round of applause again for all of the bands, because seriously, everybody rocked it, and we have to remember one thing and keep one thing in mind. We were here for a purpose today, and I have been blessed with music in my life, as have a lot of us here. And I just think that, you know, my goal, I know our goal as musicians is to make as big of a difference in the world as we can through music. So to do something like today and to just help out as much as we possibly can is what it's all about. So every musician that participated today, give yourselves a round of applause. Everybody that donated, give yourselves a round of applause, because it's all about the veterans today, and we wouldn't be here if it wasn't for them. So thank you to all our veterans that were here. Thank you, Kim, George, Rob, his wife, everybody who had a hand in today. Thank you guys so much. Woo! Thank you guys again.
Sure, you got better ones than me.
They'll be available to you. Oh, here you go. Lights help. Now maybe you can take me here now. Wait one second.
Yeah, that's better.
Oh, yeah, much better contrast.
Kim, get over there. Here you go.
Alrighty then. But there you have it, folks. You know, I know it's a good event, but I get the distinct feeling that I didn't catch everything. And I know I didn't get everything tonight. I got some. I gave you a taste. But there was just hours and hours of just incredible music. And like I said, I got some of it. There's talk of it happening next year. We can only pray, because this was another great time had by all. And on that note, ladies and gentlemen, this is Vin Shuta for Shuta Multimedia. Have a great night, everybody.